Hello, good people. Welcome to this new edition of the Press Review on JDC Plus TV. Today is Monday, January 11, and the press focuses on a number of issues. We begin with the Guardian Post, which comes back on the bloody nature of last weekend in the two English-speaking regions. Three security officers and at least seven civilians are said to have been killed in separate suspected Amber attacks, a situation which, according to the paper, raises dust over the much-heralded decentralization process, which was seen as a solution to the armed conflict plaguing the two regions. This analysis continues on page 3. In other news, the paper talks about the suicide bomb attack that killed over a dozen last week in Mozogo, a locality in the far north region. The attack was allegedly perpetrated by Boko Haram Islamic group. For more insight on this, read page 10. From the Guardian Post, we move over to the Star newspaper, which carries as main headline, Religious Leaders Dictate End of Anglophone Crisis in 2021. According to the story by Solomon Agborem, religious leaders drawn from three denominations, Roman Catholic, Protestant, and Muslim, have passed a decree to end the Anglophone crisis, which has rocked the Northwest and Southwest regions since 2016. The diktat was delivered on January 2, 2021, at the Moliko Omnisport Stadium by the men of God during a come-together dubbed National Ecumenical Week of Prayers for Peace and Justice in Cameroon. The story continues on page 2. Before moving into the next paper, we talk sports. The Star says as Shan Caravan storms the Southwest, Tarat shams Boyan Limbe fans. The caravan, which started in Yaoundé, took Tara, the Shan 2021 mascot, to the Southwest region to interact with football lovers. We keep talking Anglophone crisis, but this time around with the Voice newspaper. End the war, that's the headline proposed by the paper, which regrets that the cruel, savage and heartless killings in the Anglophone regions usher in New Year. The paper implores the heart of belligerents to be touched for the war to end. Among the steps taken by the government to end the war was the convening of the Media National Dialogue in 2019, and 15 months after the holding of this grand event, Municipal Updates makes an analysis on the impact so far from page 2 to page 10. We end this press review with the Media newspaper as we focus on the news story on Pamour. The paper says as terror escalates in Dian Division, Pamour Plantation Estate drowns in blood and fear. Two workers are said to have been killed in 1 week. Fingers of three others were chopped off. Management suggests to defense forces in the area to consider more offensive than defensive measures. For details on these and more, grab a copy of today's edition of the Media newspaper. And that does it for what the papers had to say today. Thank you so much for watching. On to our next edition.